excited to bring you what appears to be another great gridiron matchup. And here come the Tigers.
Fans on both sides think their team is going to win this thing. What's your prediction, Kirk?
Jackson State has a slight advantage in this one, guys, and it all starts on defense, especially at corner. His ability to make plays on defense is why I like them to pull this one out.
No doubt about it, Kirk. The Tigers are coming out on top.
We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Short kickoff. Number 84 fields it at the 26. Now let's see what kind of success this offense can have as they come on onto the field for the first time today. They'll go to work at the 42-yard line. They come out with a big set. Fullback straight ahead. He's hit and got away. And he's taken down at the 46. A monster run there by the fullback.
You're right, Brad. That was a scary run for this defense.
Coach, scary or not, you got to wrap the big guy up. You can't allow the fullback to run wild like that on your defense.
They're in the eye. At the 46-yard line, nothing gained on the play. Second down.
Ball on the 46-yard line.
And down he goes at the 41-yard line. About 5 yards there on the fullback carry. Third and five. Ball on the 41-yard line. The Spartans go with the I formation. The give to the fullback. He's taken down at the 38-yard line. No can do on that run. That'll bring up fourth down.
Boy, you're absolutely right. Those guys got in there and shut them down, and now they're all fired up.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. Two tight ends here. Get out there on the toss. Tackled for a loss, and they'll turn it over on downs. Not quite enough for the first. Looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
Yeah, it was worth the gamble, even though they didn't make it.
Guys, is there any question as to who the star player on this offense is?
It all starts on the ground, Brad. And one player I think this team can't do without is this kid at tailback.
Yeah, if I had to predict a player of the game right now, then I'd put my money on this running back. If this kid doesn't go over 100 yards today, I'd be very surprised.
Me too.
Incomplete pass.
Yo, that was a tough pass for him to hold on to.
Yeah, but it wasn't the pass that was the problem. The hit is what jarred the ball loose.
Hey, the quarterback is the one who left his wide receiver out to dry. You have to throw those passes in a place where the guy could protect himself.
Number 9 lines up in the shotgun. Gives it off. They'll knock him down for a loss. And that was a good stop by the defense. They got him in the backfield.
That's a great example of quickness by the defensive line. It allows you to break away from those blockers before they have a chance of moving you away from the play.
Third and 13. Ball on the 38. They'll bring in their dime package. Steps up in the pocket. He's looking for his man at the 40. He could go to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Tigers.
They made a great connection there for the touchdown, didn't they, Phil?
Boy, the quarterback threw a strike to the wide receiver. He caught it, took it all away.
But what a dangerous combination. You can't say enough about how good that throw was. The quarterback put that one right on the money.
Here's the kicking team to try the extra point. And he adds the extra point. And under 3 minutes to go in the first quarter. The score, Jackson State, 7. Norfolk State, nothing. Jackson State is lining up to kick this one off. Kicks off. Number 20 fields it at the 26. The offense saw their last drive end on fourth down. Will we see a similar result this time? First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Number 3 comes to the line with 3 wide. Counterplay. And he's taken down at midfield. A 4-yard pickup on the counter by the fullback. Second and 6. They line up at the 50. Norfolk State lines up in a double tight set. And they make the stop at the 46. The fullback gains about 4 yards there. Third and 2 coming up here. Ball on the 46. Norfolk State comes out with an I formation. Fumble. It's picked up by the defense. And he's hammered down. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
He saw the ball pop out and just went after it. Nice hustle.
It sure was. It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit and he played to the whistle. First and 10.
Jackson State comes out with 5 receivers. Looks to pass. Throws it out there. And it falls incomplete. Number 10 was the intended target on the play. That'll bring up second down. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Number 9 with 3 wide receivers. Drops back to pass. Batted ball. The defender had it and then dropped it. Poor decision to throw it into such tight coverage. From their own 45-yard line, third and 10. Number 9 has 4 receivers lined up here. Broke away from one. Throws it. He's tackled at the 46. They'll get a good chunk of yards on that play, but they're still looking at fourth down.
Maybe that will perk these guys up a bit and get them going on the next drive.
The Tigers are lining up to punt it away. It's a short kick. Signals for a fair catch. The offense heads out onto the field. In their last series, they opted to try and convert a fourth down, and they came up short. They'll take over at the 28-yard line. 2 tight ends here. Play fake. He's looking down the middle. He's got his tight end. And he's tackled at the 42. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
And the quarterback did a tremendous job of the fake handoff, too.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 42. They line up in a double tight set. Gives it off. And he's level at the 42-yard line. They gave the fullback a shot at picking up yardage, but he couldn't get anything.
That was a beautiful thing to see that defense crash in and bust up the play.
They line up at the 42. Second down and 10 to go. The Tigers line up in a nickelback. Here's the give. They'll bring him down at the 47. He's not your ordinary fullback. This guy can move.
You bet he can. I like this kid. He's a heck of a football player. They need to get him some more carries.
First and 10. Ball on the 47. Number 3 comes to the line with 3 wide. Taken down at the 46. And the fullback plows ahead for maybe a yard. We've got second and 9 here. Ball on the 46-yard line. After a quarter of play, our score is Jackson State 7, Norfolk State nothing. It's second and 9. Ball on the 46. He'll go with the fullback. And he's tackled at the 44. He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. They line up at the 44. Third down. The Spartans are lining up with 3 receivers. They'll bring him down at the 43. Not much on that play, and they'll be short of the first.
I think the offense thought they'd be able to get past this defense, but they were wrong.
Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Number 12, the return man. He gets it away, and it's a skyrocket. Signals for a fair catch. Not a whole lot of success their last time out.
Not at all. This offense has to do a better job of staying on the field and giving their defense a chance to catch their breath.
The offense will start at the 19. Jackson State comes out in the shotgun. Tackle at the 26. And a pickup of about 7.
7 yards.
Second down, 3 yards to go. Ball on the 26. Three-man front defensively. They hand it off again. He jukes it. He's taken down at the 32. A good carry for the first down.
You guys know I like running players with the lead blocker. But if they can run consistently like they are right now, it doesn't matter how they're blocking it. As long as they block, they're going to make yards.
As long as it's within the rules of the game, right, Lee?
They'll bring in their dime package. Play action. No one open, so he's going to run. And they make the stop at the 41. Second down and around 1 to go. Ball on the 41. Norfolk State lines up with 5 defensive backs. Hands it off.
Man, I sure wouldn't want to be hit by that kid.
That's not baby fat on him anymore. He weighs 300 pounds plus. I don't know if I'd be calling him a kid.
Well, I'm not the one out there taking hits either, my friend.
They line up at the 41. It's third down and a yard for the first down. The Tiger set up in the gun. On play action. Juke move. And they got to him before he could get back to the line. Loss of about two. The Tigers are lining up to punt it away. Number 36 is waiting for the snap. Number 36 punts it and he didn't get much distance on it. So the offense takes over and they'll try to figure out this defense as they forced them to punt the last time they had the ball. They'll get the ball here at the 44. Three wideouts here. Oh man, did he take a hit. Norfolk State will take their first time out of the half. Two minutes left in the half. Norfolk State in a four wide set. Goes to the back. And he's tackled at the 47. Gain of a yard by the fullback.
1 yard gain on the play.
Third and seven coming up here. The Spartans are lining up with three receivers. Tackle at the 48. The defense calls a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. Norfolk State lining up to punt. Number six, back deep to return.
Number six.
He punt. No, he faked it. I don't think that one worked the way it was planned.
Now they rolled the dice here, but the up man just couldn't get the ball to the first down.
They line up at the 49. It's first down. They come out with three wide receivers. Setting up play action. He steps up. They'll make the sack. They line up at the 44. Second and long coming up here. Six DBs in the lineup. Steps up in the pocket. He'll dump it short. And it's picked off. He's taken down at the 36. The defensive end comes up with a big, big interception.
Boy, he made a super play there. Defensive ends aren't supposed to catch passes.
Yeah, but some of these guys today have better hands than you think, Coach. That gives them an advantage in the passing game.
Norfolk State takes the field, looking to tie it up before halftime. Two tight ends set. Inside handoff. Bounces off the would-be tackler. And they make the stop at the 28. Norfolk State will take a timeout. That was their second timeout. From the 28-yard line, second down. Number three with three wide receivers. surveys the field. He passes it. He snags it. And he's taken down at the 22. Gain of 6 on the pass, and that's good for a first down.
This is a hard play to contain if you're a defensive player. If you give him too much of a cushion, then the quarterback can hit the receiver with the short route. If you stay on top of him, then he just might try and beat you deep.
And they couldn't hook up on that one. The receiver didn't have a chance on that one. From the 22-yard line, it's 2nd and 10. Single set backfield. Drops back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Across the middle. And it's the tight end. The tight end with a nice catch there. The Spartans go with the I formation. He's under pressure. They brought him down for the sack at the 10-yard line. Norfolk State comes out in the shotgun, looks to pass. He throws, and he gets the touchdown. The quarterback threw a pretty ball there for the touchdown.
But don't forget about the catch. The receiver made one heck of a grab, too.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. Down to just a few seconds left here before the half. And our score, Norfolk State, 7. Jackson State, 7. Kickoff. Short kickoff. Number 83 fields it at the 26. But hold on, we got a penalty on the play. Let's check it out.
Holding on the receiving team. 10 yards.
Beep.
First down.
Beep. Beep.
Speeder, what are you doing?
Kirk, my friend, that's the sound of the offense going in reverse.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 33. Jackson State comes to the line with 3 wide. Steps up, looks. That's a great tackle at the 28-yard line. It's 2nd and 15. Ball on their own 28. And we've got a tie ball game here, folks, and we pause for halftime. And we're just about set to get things underway here in the second half. And this one's away. Number 18 takes it to 25. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. Made at the 48-yard line. Number 3 comes away with 2 yards on the carry. That'll make it 2nd down. Second and 8. Ball on their own 48. They come out in a five-wide set. Back to pass. Stepping up. He rolls out to the left. He throws left. And he's taken down at the 47-yard line. Will they pick up a few with a pass play, Coach?
Yeah, it was. I like plays like these. As long as you're moving forward and not backward, you're doing pretty good.
From the 47-yard line, it's third and three. Jackson State lines up in a goal line set. Setting up play action. Throws it to the outside. He's tackled in the open field.
The defense was coming with heat on that play.
Yep, but the offensive line did a good job of picking up their assignments. And that gave the quarterback enough time to throw a nice pass to pick up the first down.
They line up at the 37. First down. The Tiger set up in the gun. They'll throw on first down. Incomplete pass. Number 49 was the intended receiver on the play. So that'll make it second down. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 37. Single set back to you. Fakes to the back. Across the middle. Catches it. They'll bring him down at the 16. That one worked pretty well.
It was a good job here by the wide receiver to get open. He created good separation from the defense.
It's first and 10. They're in the red zone.
Ball on the 16-yard line.
The Tigers are lining up with three receivers. Looks like he's going to run.
Number nine with the carry. 1 yard gain on the play.
Second and nine. Ball on the 15. The Tigers come out showing three wide. He zips it out to the left, and it's caught, and he's tackled in the open field. About 6 yards on that completion. So another third down upcoming for the offense. Number nine is back in the gun. Setting up the play action. He lets it go. And he comes up with his second touchdown catch of the game right there.
Kirk, this kid is tough to stop.
Yeah, you're right, Coach. You try to keep tabs on him, but eventually he's going to find a way to get open.
I think you need to double team him.
So they're ready for the extra point. He makes the PAT. So under 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. And the score, Jackson State 14, Norfolk State 7. Jackson State gets set to kick this one away. Number 84 and number 20 set to return. Kicks it away. Number 84 fields it at the 26. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. They'll go to work at the 41. The Spartans are lining up with three receivers. Looking, moves up in the pocket. Throws it deep downfield. He goes down at the 23-yard line. The wideout comes up with a spectacular play.
Yeah, and if I'm the coach, I put a big circle around that play so I can remember to call that one again. Good call.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball in the 23. The Spartans line up with a single set back to him. He's taken down at the 19-yard line. That's 4 yards on the play. From the 19-yard line, it's second and six. The Spartans line up with two tight ends. Back to pass. Surveys the field. And he's sacked. They'll line up at the 25. Third down and 12 to go. The Spartans come out in the shotgun. Steps up. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Sack for a loss at the 34-yard line. The defensive end showed his athleticism getting to the quarterback.
When you send blitzers like that, you try to confuse the offensive line and get someone free.
Well, the only one confused is the quarterback because he wants to know why they let the big guy be the one who got free.
Looks like they're going to punt it away here. Number 11 awaits the snap. Number 11 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. Calls for the fair catch. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for six.
And great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
They'll take over at the six. They use four linebackers. Juku, and he's level at the 9 yard line. And the halfback carry for a pickup of three. It's second and seven. Ball on the nine. The Tigers are lining up with three receivers. Throws. The ball is tipped. Number 83 was the intended target, so that'll make it third down. It's third down and seven to go. Jackson State in a four wide set, looks, lets it fly. And this one falls incomplete. Number 18 was the intended receiver on that pass. They're going to be forced to punt it away here. It's fourth down, and the punt team lines up. Number 84 is back to receive.
Number 84, back to return.
Number 36 punts it, and it doesn't look like he got all of that one. Number 84 signals for a fair catch. I don't know if you guys saw this, but the coach gave his offense quite a speech before he sent him out there.
And let's not forget, they had some things clicking the last time out. He's probably just reminding them to finish the job this time.
The offense will start at the 33. He's looking to pass. Looking across the middle. And that one's fallen incomplete. Number 40 was the intended target. That'll bring up second down. So at the end of three quarters, it's only a one-possession game with the score. Jackson State, 14. Norfolk State, 7. From the 33-yard line, second down, 10 yards to go. They come out with three wide receivers. Inside handoff. They'll bring him down at the 15. And the fullback picks up the first.
I think they caught the defense a little off guard.
You're probably right. Huge gain there on the ground.
Number three has trips to the right. He's tackled at the 9-yard line, about 6 yards on the play. From the 9-yard line, it's second down and four to go. The offense lines up with three wide receivers. They'll give it off here. That's a great tackle. At the nine, no gain. It's third down. Norfolk State sets up in the eye. Looks to pass. Steps up in the pocket. He rolls left. Fires to the end zone. A great throw, and that's his second touchdown catch of the game.
The quarterback knew exactly where to put the pass, and the receiver went out there and made the grab. Good communication there.
They'll line it up for the extra point. Tacks on the extra point. So with less than 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter, our score, Norfolk State 14, Jackson State 14. Number 47 is lined up to kick this one off.
Number 83, back deep to return.
He kicks it. Number 83 fields it at the 26. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
The offense looked a bit out of sync on that last possession, Coach.
And it was the defense that threw them out of sync, Kirk. Those guys are fired up. Let's see if they can hold them again.
They'll set up shop at the 42-yard line. Number 9 comes to the line with three wide. Little handoff. Sheds that one. And he's tackled at the 48. That's a 10-yard gain. From the 48-yard line. Second down. Number 9 lines up in the shotgun. He's looking, stepping up. He's hit and got away. He's going right, and he's hit immediately. Number 10 picks him up around 7 yards with that catch.
And how about the poise of this quarterback to locate his receiver past the sticks and get him the ball? That was a great throw.
First and 10, ball on the 41-yard line. Norfolk State brings in the nickel here. The running back has it. And down he goes at the 34-yard line. Number 3 gets 7 yards on the play. It's second down and 3 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. They come out with three wide receivers. Steps up in the pocket. He throws it. It's complete. Drop back 4 yards on that one.
Loss of four on the play.
It's third down.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
The Tigers come out in the shotgun, surveys the field. He lets it go, and he's got him again. Brought down at the 17.
I'll tell you, this receiver showed really good hands on that play.
This kid is always calling for the ball, and if he keeps making plays like that, he'll continue to get the ball.
We'll see what they can do in the red zone. Norfolk State lines up defensively in a 3-4. They line up at the 17. Second and 10. Jackson State comes to the line with three wide. He'll get it again. He's tackled at the 15. Number three gains about 2 yards on the run. So that'll make it third down. There you have it, folks. They really earned it out there today. The Tigers are lining up with three receivers. On a counter. And down he goes at the 8. Norfolk State will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. Fourth down. This will be a 25-yarder. It's up, and the field goal is good. So they take the late lead with that clutch field goal.
Wow!
Wow is an understatement. That was a big kick.
This has been a great game from start to finish, folks. It's a shame that one of these teams has to lose this game.
Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Number 84, back to return.
Kicks it away. He drops it. Number 84 fields it to 31. So what do you think about this situation, fellas?
A field goal will tie it, and a touchdown will win it.
Yep, but the clock is a big factor right now. I'm interested in seeing what they're going to try and do here, Coach.
They'll go to work at the 33. Norfolk State lines up with three receivers. They'll throw on first down. He looks, fires, got it. And he's all the way down to the 39. Norfolk State will have one timeout remaining. First and 10, ball on the 39-yard line. The Spartans line up with three wide. He drops back, moves up in the pocket, looks under pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play. Gets the ball. No, they fake it. He delivers. Caught. Tackle at the 29. And a pretty smart call right there.
You're absolutely right. The reason why this play worked is that the play action throws the defense just enough to allow the receiver to get open.
He looks to throw on first down. Catches it. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 24-yard line. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
Second and 5. Ball on the 24-yard line. They'll throw again. Defense hasn't stopped them yet. That's a backward pass. It's a live ball.
Boy, were they lucky on that one.
A turnover this late in the game would have almost ended their chances.
You're right, Coach. That would have been devastating.
Norfolk State will use their final timeout. From the 35-yard line, we've got third and long here. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. There's the final gun, and this game is history. Kirk, what'd you think of this one?
I'm sad to see this one end because it was a great game to watch. Norfolk State played a good game out there, but they needed to make one or two more big plays, and they couldn't do it. Who knows? Another couple of minutes, and this one may have gone the other way.
Folks, it's been a lot of fun, and I hope you can join us again next time. Our final score on this one, Jackson State, 17, Norfolk State, 14.